You are my freedom to lift you higher.
Oh, this is a great one.
Love enough, nothing can set us.
Whoa. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is Toxic Toss Thursdays. I'm Amy Sunseri. And every week we get on here, let me turn this down. Oh, that's such a great one. We get on here and we discuss something toxic, right? What does that all mean? Well, we talk about either a product found in the home, a chemical we make, a DIY, a do-it-yourself, something that's more natural, right? And we're just teaching you so you can literally ditch and switch, right? You can ditch your toxic items and you can switch to more natural, safe items. And the saying goes, when you know better, you do better. And that is so, so, so the truth. And I literally started this series to share because I was one of those who in the past didn't know better, right? So my life, my house was just filled with toxins. So what do I mean? Well, my beauty care products, my makeup, everything that we put on our skin, everything that we were cleaning with in our house, literally was filled with toxic chemicals. And when I learned about this product topic, and I learned about the toxic chemicals that are lingering in products, I was absolutely shocked. And I said, you know what? We got to do something about this. It's something that's not mainstream, something that's not talked about. So let's get on here and talk about it, right? Okay, so today, this is exciting. We are talking about dish soap. Woo! We all got to do the dishes, right? We got to eat, right? So we eat off of our dishes and whatnot. So we want to learn about this, right? Because we don't want to be consuming toxic chemicals off of our plates, right? When we're eating. So first off, before we get started, I just want to share some statistics. I know I've shared this in the past, but for those of you who might be new to watching the videos, maybe you don't know this. So these are just some statistics. The number two cause of death in the United States is cancer. So 1 in 3 cases are directly linked to poor diet, physical inactivity, weight, or chemical exposure. Only 5% of cancer-causing cases are from our genes. So that means that 95% of cancer-causing cases are under our control. It's what we allow in our own homes, right? From our products, from the cleaning products to the personal care items and more. And did you know that it only takes 26 seconds after exposure of the chemicals that they can be found in measurable amounts in one's human body? Some of the most dangerous chemicals in our home are our cleaning supplies, items that we really just, we use nonstop, right? We use them to clean our homes, clean our dishes, clean our clothes. And for this week's Toxic Toss Thursday, we're talking about dish soap. And think about this, you know, I just mentioned it, but you don't want to clean your dishes filled with chemicals, right? That you're going to consume, right? I mean, that doesn't really make sense, right? We're eating off of these. So what are some of the top toxins that are found? One is sodium lauryl, also known as SLS, sulfate. So it can be known as sodium lauryl sulfate, sodium lauryl sulfate, or SLS. They hide it in their different ways. So what is this? Let's dig deeper. And if you guys see me looking to the side, that's because my notes are over there. So this is an inexpensive toxin that is commonly used in cosmetic cleansers, hair shampoos, baths, shower gels, bubble baths, as well as dish soaps. It's probably one of the most dangerous ingredients that is used in skin and hair care products. So why, right? In the cleaning industry, SLS, the sodium lauryl sulfate, is used in garage floor cleaners, engine degreasers, car shampoo, and wash soaps, and it's very corrosive and readily attacks greasy surfaces. So think about that, and then being on our skin, right? So sodium lauryl sulfate is used throughout the world for clinical testing as a primary skin irritant. Laboratories use it to irritate the skin, right? To irritate test animals, humans, so that they may then test healing agents to see how effectively they can once the skin is irritated. a study at the University of Georgia Medical Center, Medical College, excuse me, indicated that SLS penetrated into the eyes as well as the brain, heart, liver. It showed long-term retention in the tissues. The study also indicated that SLS penetrated young children's eyes and prevented them from developing properly and caused cataracts to develop in adults. SLS may cause hair loss by attacking the follicles. It's classified as a drug in bubble baths because it eats away the skin protection and causes rash and infections to occur. It also dries by stripping the protective lipids from the surface so that it can effectively regulate moisturizer. So another serious problem that is in connection with SLS is the nitrate contamination. So SLS reacts with many types of ingredients used in skincare products in forms of nitrates. Nitrates are potential cancer-causing carcinogens. So moving along, right? Lastly, with the SLS, that is the ingredient, the sodium lauryl sulfate, that makes the soap suds, right? So it's creating this soapy feeling, right? Sudsing all up. And do you think maybe it does that to make us think that our items are cleaner, right? Your dishes, your all of that. But that's just due to that toxin, okay? So next, moving along, we want to talk about dyes briefly. Dyes, D-Y-E-S. So many dish soaps also have dyes in them, right? Why are they bad? Well, they're bad because it's a mixture of many chemicals made from coal tar, a derivative of petroleum. Aluminum compounds and many heavy metals have been found in many dyes. They're toxic to the brain, so obviously you don't want to be consuming things like that, right, from your dishes. And then, of course, the chemicals that we can't go without because they're in everything. We talk about it pretty much every week. The fragrances, synthetic perfumes, synthetic parfums, and the formaldehyde. So if you guys haven't gotten it by yet, those are bad ones, right? So you might love the smell of your dish soap, right? But the fragrance smell is, of course, linked to allergies, skin irritation, eczema, could be toxic to various organs in the body. So that term fragrance, we've talked about this before as well, right? Just a loophole for hundreds of thousands of chemicals. The formaldehyde can be in there, and you don't know what they are because they're not regulated, and they have tons of dangerous effects on the body. So obviously, you just don't want that in your product. So what do I do? What can you do? Well, obviously, label read, right? When you know better, you do better. Check for these chemicals, checks for these toxins. So what do I use? So I use one from Young Living. So this is the Young Living Thieves Dish Soap. I like this because it's free from those chemicals, right? It's free from the sodium lauryl sulfate, free from the dyes, free from the formaldehyde, free from the synthetic perfume. It is a plant-based essential oil-infused dish soap. So not only can I clean my dishes, but then I can eat off of them and know that those nasty chemicals aren't coming into my body, right? Win-win. So I like this because one bottle, it is highly concentrated. You can actually dilute out into 4 bottles. That's right. So if you save your empty bottles, you can make 4 dish soaps with one bottle. That's pretty awesome, right? That's a little hack that you can do. So that's really great. That's what my family does. So remember, simply choose safer alternatives, right? You are the gatekeepers of your own homes. You're the only one that's going to decide what comes in and what you and your family are using. And if you guys want any more information about any of the products that I discuss, that I go over, from the Young Living products to the oils to whatnot, please send me a personal message and I'd be happy to help you and to have you learn some more about them. Okay, so next week, this is exciting. I want to hear from you guys, right? I don't have something planned out yet. I want you to be able to help me in planning that out. So simply comment below. Let me know, what are some things you want to learn about? What are some things you're questioning? Whether it's chemicals, whether it's the different products, whether it's an oil, anything natural in that realm, you let me know, you comment below, and then we're going to pick a topic from those comments to be discussed next week for our Toxic Toss Thursdays. All right, guys, thanks again for watching. This is Amy Sunseri with Natural Wellness with Amy Sunseri and Toxic Toss Thursdays.